Everyone, it is EBM360 here, or EBM360 if you want to call me, and today we are back with another video, and today I'm with my friend Bobby. And in this video we're actually going to be opening up three phones. We're going to be opening up the iPhone 4, 5 and 6, and we're just going to be showing you the tutorial on how to open it up, what's inside, that sort of stuff. It might be a longer video, towards 30 minutes long. As long as that can be. Just gonna close this cupboard. Bobby actually, his parents own a shop. It's called Pro Case, and it's in Melbourne, Victoria. Pro Case Melbourne. Link down below. On the address to that. Go visit it. It's a very good store. I've bought many things off it, including, thanks Bobby. This thing which I put my iPad in for school. It's just a case, and it's really protective. It's got bubbles and stuff. A really good case. Their prices are good, and their quality and their service is so good. So go check them out. Link in the description. First of all, Bobby, get over here. Let's start doing this. So first of all, stupid iPhone 4. I'm actually recording with my iPhone 5 at the moment. And then these are all Bobby's phones, and he's got more. So this is the iPhone 4, and we're gonna open that up one up first. So what you're going to do is, we've got this tool here, and we've got this tool, so they're like screwdrivers, another screwdriver, and like tweezer things. So Bobby, just sit down there, like we did before. With this screwdriver, it's a pretty thin one, it's just a normal one that you'd use in the backyard or wherever. You're going to see two things here, two screws on each side of the lightning port, while the charging area. You're gonna unscrew them. I'm gonna get Bobby to do that. With the red one, sorry. So make sure they're showing the camera. Yeah, Bobby, that's a good job. You can see me behind, just chilling. Quickly unscrew that. Screws are at the bottom. So Bobby, I'm just gonna be filming. Let's just put these iPhones down. So the screws now are actually, they're out. And now what we're gonna wanna do is, on the back of the iPhone 4, there's a back cover. You're gonna slide that forward. You're gonna slide it forward. You're gonna hear a little click. That area is gonna be undone, and then you're just gonna take it off nicely. At Bobby's shop, Pro Case, you can get black or white ones, and you can change them. I think they're $5, are they? Five? Change them so you can have a white one on a white iPhone, or a black one. Like you see here, Bobby's changed everything. We can do that for you. So that's that. Once that is off, we'll just put that back there. Bobby's now going to show you how to take out the battery, and then we're going to show you the screen of the phone. So what Bobby's, because Bobby's the pro, I just learnt today. What Bobby's now going to do is he's going to unscrew this little one down here towards the battery. So when you've got the phone like that, turn it around, hold it Bobby, and then there's a little thing down here. You can tell that this phone is bad. It's got a tiny bit of water damage done to it. The water damage, you know, because it's got that little red spot. So that's usually white. And if it goes red, it means a water damage. It's not fully water damage, but it's got a little bit of water damage. So, we've got water damage done there, but that's all right. The phone still works. It is jailbroken. And now, Bobby, what he's going to do is he's going to take the battery out. So, as I said, we're going to undo that little silver thing. Take that out. It just, like, slides off. Then you can take this out, comes out with the battery. There we go. If we move the battery to the side, now what Bobby's going to do is he's going to take the things apart, and he's going to take off the screen of that phone, iPhone 4. So what he's going to do is he's going to take off the screen. So Bobby, take off the screen. So to take off the screen, you've taken off the battery. That's the battery and its little screw thing. Up here, where Bobby's putting the screwdriver, there's a little screw. You take that off. Magnetic. There we go. Easy done. And put that on the ground. It's going to take another one off now. This channel, guys, was meant to be on gaming and stuff. I'm actually going to be doing more tech video things type like this. How to get free stuff on Android and iPhones. That sort of stuff. So now Bobby, you take that little flap off. This is iPhone 4, a little flap, right? Good. Now what Bobby's going to do is he's going to continue to try and take off the screen. The camera, which is what we take off now. He's actually unscrewing screws from the motherboard, which is the, like, your computer's brain, sort of. It's like the CPU, your friend's brain. After this, we're going to go to the iPhone 5. We're going to take a look at, again, that's customized, and then we're going to go to an iPhone 6, and we've got a bit of a story with the iPhone 6 on what Bobby did. So yeah, guys, if you are enjoying, I hope you can see me. If you are enjoying this video, leave a like. My hair's probably stuffed up. Bobby and I both would really appreciate it. So yeah, we're just gonna continue. He unscrewed that little area up here next to the camera, and now he's just gonna take the camera out, and then we're gonna continue with the screen. Okay, Bobby, when you're doing it, just your hands out of the way. That's right. Yeah, so he just took the camera. This is the camera. This is your camera on your phone. It's like a 2-megapixel camera. It's crap on the iPhone 4. Now he's going to take that little area out. It's a little flap. Oh, my camera. Alright, he took the camera out, as I said. Now Bobby's just going to still continue to take at the screen. Like, probably telling us right now, saying in your own little lives, how the hell do you take this out? How the hell do you all know what this means? And why the hell is it taking so long? Well, you need to be careful. One tip also, make sure your phone is turned off, just for safety purposes. Make sure your phone is turned off. So now Bobby, what he's gonna do, use that little pointy area, that thing. It's like an envelope opener. He's gonna open that little, it's a little thing there. Quickly twist it. Bobby, your hand. Yep. Perfect. SIM card. The SIM card now. He's got the little SIM card called tools. Yep. You're going to go to the side of the phone and take out the SIM card. So once your SIM card is out, you're going to continue to take out more screws and stuff and put the phone, take the screen off the phone. So Bobby, you continue with that. Alright, so he's taking out more screws. Hope you enjoy this video, guys. Just out of the blue, anyway, just give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. We will have daily, weekend videos coming out. Sorry, had to cut off. Bobby, now, he took out the motherboard of the phone. This is the base of the phone. This is... Without a phone, this doesn't do anything. Same in the computer, same in everything. Motherboard, this is a main part of the computer. This is the most essential thing, the computer. Just going to put that down there. Try not to have your fingers on it too much, otherwise it might wreck it. Now, the phone's empty. Like, it's literally empty. There's nothing in it. Just a few bits and bobs. You're going to unscrew. There's a screw at the bottom of the phone. The charging port area. Screw comes out. That is where you charge the phone. So when the iPhone's open, show me about it. It's got that little charging port, the old phones, and then behind that is this little black thing that just sits like there. And then that's where the charger goes into, and then it hits into the battery somewhere. Touches it onto another area which touches onto the battery. So Bobby's still gonna continue to take out the screen. We're just gonna do a little bit of a fix of taking out the screws on the side. So there's like little screws on each corner and each area near the corner. And once you've taken those out, you'll be nearly there taking the screen out. So Bobby's still going. It's not an easy task to do. But while he's doing that, he's just going to undo those side screws. While he's doing that, I'm going to tell you a story about what happened with the iPhone 6. So Bobby's parents, they own the store. They own Procase in Melbourne. Go there, guys. I'm not joking. Please go there. It's a really good shop. And Bobby finds all these spare bits and pieces in his mum and dad's shop. And he decided to make his own phone, which is good of Bobby. Very good at Bobby, he's smart. He made his own phone. This is iPhone 6 is not charged. It doesn't work, but it turns on. It has the white screen with the little black Apple logo. It works. It turns on, but doesn't do anything apart from that. Everything. iPhone 6S. It is an iPhone 6S. So, congratulations on Bobby. Bobby has now taken out every screw on the side, and he's ready to take out the screen. So, what he's going to do now, all the screws are undone. And Bobby, just hold the camera. So, now you're just going to push. Oops, I'm not that good at this. Push. Isn't that right, Bobby? No. Slide. No, it's not slide. Take out. I knew it was one of them. You can take out. It's got pricks. Make sure you take it out a bit of one side and then a bit on the other side. And there you go. It's still connected by a few little cords, so you can take them out easily. Home buttons. This is how we change them. Put a new one in and swatch it around. That is the iPhone 4 screen. Take a look at that. Look how thin. Super thin. That's how it is. So, good job, Bobby. We took apart a whole iPhone 4. He's going to turn it back on and show you it works perfectly. Look at this. This is an iPhone 4. Look at all this crap lying on the ground. That's all bits and pieces of iPhone 4. Bobby's going to put that back together, and I'm going to head on with the iPhone 5. Let's do this thing. So, now, iPhone 5, a very popular phone. Lots of people have them. I'm going to get on with doing that one, and I'm going to first just say something. This one here, you see, it doesn't have the screws next to the lightning port. No screws. So that doesn't matter. Big deal. Bobby took them out because he's done it so many times. With the phone, to start off with, you're going to need... he's just fixing an iPhone 4 up. Well, I am going to head on with this iPhone 5. Just going to bend the camera down a bit. Hope my tripod doesn't break like it always does. All right, that's perfect. With the iPhone 6, by the way. So what's going to happen now, guys, is down here, just beneath the home button, there's going to be this little area. Obviously, since Bobby's taken this phone apart so many times, it's a bit worn out. But there's still a little area that you can put your little knife thingy into. So you're just going to put that under the home button. Be firm with it. I just use my palms like this. So you just put that knife thing, you dig in, it's fine, it's not going to break. And then you'll eventually get the screen. See that? Taking it out. Lift it up. You can take off the screen of the iPhone 5. Oops, fell back on. That is the iPhone 5 now, guys. Take a look inside of what all your iPhone 5s look like. The iPhone 4 is definitely the hardest phone because the two things don't come apart. The iPhone 4, you have to take everything out, whereas this, it's a bit different. Whereas the iPhone 4, it doesn't like fold out. It's got the back cover and you have to take everything out to do the screen. So this one where you just take the screen off and we could change it. So we have to take out a few screws, which Bobby, we might do. I mean, the iPhone 4 was probably the most interesting one of all of the phones. I might just show you the battery. So to take out the battery, I'm actually going to need this screwdriver here. We're going to take out these metal plates. So those metal plates, that one and that one. Oh, sorry, I'll show that again. This plate and this plate up here. We're just going to unscrew them. I still don't know which way is which. Is it this way, Bobby?
Yeah.
Anti-clockwise? Or maybe not. No, this is clockwise. It's this. You don't have the screw. Which one? There's no screw. Can I just take it out? Oh my god, I was wheeling in an empty spot. You stupid little Bobby. I knew that I was doing it right and then there was no screw. You just take out. These are magnetic. So it's just gonna... It's magnetic. Little screw, tiny little screw. Focus. That's it. Tiny little screw. Take this plate off now. Bobby's lost the other two screws. Little plate. put that next to the screw. Now, one more area until we take off the battery. My tripod fell apart. Let's just fix this quickly. Oh, yeah, so guys, I was just saying to Bobby that iPhone 4 isn't actually an easy one to do. He's just using the screwdriver at the moment, but while he's doing that and he's putting iPhone 4 back together, I'm just going to say, once again, go to the shop, alright? If you can, if you live in another country, that's alright. But if you live in Melbourne, whenever you pass any of the Pro Case stores, go to the shop. They're pretty good. The postage is alright. There is postage, isn't there, Bobby? Yeah, so it's a really good site. Like, as I said, I've got this beautiful case. It's got bubbles inside. It's so protective. We fix screens. This isn't actually an iPhone 4 screen that we have to fix for a friend. It's brand new. We're gonna do it tomorrow. We have to insert it. So, yeah. See you guys back. Bobby's just gonna finish the iPhone 4, and then we will get onto the iPhone 6 once I take the battery out of the iPhone 5. Peace out. All right, guys. Bobby's finished with the screwdriver, and now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna undo the last little plate thing, and I found a screw here. I don't know which frame's this from. iPhone 5 maybe? iPhone 5. That's the one from the back, yeah. So, iPhone 4, sorry. What we're going to do now with the screwdriver is just going to take out this last little plate. We're not going to take out the screen of the iPhone 5. That might happen in another video. So, here there's just this little plate thing here. Bobby, could you just use the camera for a sec? And what we're going to do, see this little plate down here? Let's zoom in a bit. You see this little plate here, guys? What we're going to do, I'm going to use... Wrong way. Which way is it? This way? This way. The iPhone 5 screws, some of them take a while to come out, but I think I got it. Here we go. There's one. Two. You have to push really hard. You have to be firm. Two. Last one. Three. So these screwdrivers are magnetic. Point to the thing. Bobby, hold my phone. They are magnetic. It helps a lot. Last one. Now I'm just going to take these little plates off. One, two. And we're going to use this little thing here quickly. That's the battery for the iPhone 5. So zoom out, Bobby. That's the iPhone 5's battery. Now Bobby and I are just going to fix up these frames. And we are going to do the iPhone 6. So, peace out. So, we got the iPhone 5 working again. We were just testing it because we thought something went wrong, but it didn't because our tutorials are good. See, when that comes out, the screen turns off. So, what we're going to do now, Bobby, is put this screen back in. So, could you put the screen back in, please? Just going to finish the screw. Put the screen back in, then I'm going to put those last two few screws on, then the iPhone 5 will turn on, and we've got proof that it is going to work. So Bobby is very intelligent like this stuff. All good?
Yeah.
Bobby, I need to put these last things in. So guys, now what's going to happen quickly is Bobby is going to put the last few screws and stuff back into the iPhone 5. Then I'm going to get onto the iPhone 6. With the iPhone 6, we're not going to take any screens off, any batteries out. What we're going to do is I'm just going to show you what's inside it. And then we're going to finish the video up. This channel, as I said before, is more going to be now about tech. There will definitely be gaming videos. A few vlogs now and then. But that will only happen if you could... give thumbs up and get to a high subscribing point for my channel. Bobby will be showed in a lot of tech videos that we do. He will be in the more opening up phones and stuff. He'll be in a lot of those because obviously I'm a noob at that. I'm a newbie. Bobby's done that for heaps of years. On the phone that I'm recording with an iPhone 5. It's a normal iPhone 5 and I've got that Touch ID home button because I switched it this morning with Bobby. I did it myself. I put it in. So that's good. Look like my iPhone SE now. Totally does. 100%. What Bobby's now going to do is magnetic, and he's going to put the last screw in. Last screw. Close up the whole thing, which I'll put the screen down, and as you can see, it's on. It's ready for his password. His password's simple. He can change it. It's pure. It works. You see that? It works perfectly. Look, Siri. Siri. Siri and everything. Except he doesn't have Wi-Fi. Siri. Hey, Siri. In my videos, I will be showing you guys how to do this. Because that's not normal. How to get things everywhere. Oops. So, if you hear noises in the background, I'm sorry. It's my brother, the cool gamer. You probably watch videos with him screaming. Because he wants to play, I don't know, computers. And he lost the level in COD. I think he died. I'll be teaching you guys how to do this, how to get round folders. You can get round folders and stuff. I'll teach you guys how to do that. All that sort of stuff. Bobby's is in Chinese because he's been in Australia for a year and his English is amazing, Bobby. You're Houdini. So that iPhone 5 works perfectly. Boom. That is shut off. That iPhone 5 is perfect. Now what Bobby's doing is just finishing off the iPhone 4 because the iPhone 4 does take a long time. I could take off the screen of an iPhone 6 and an iPhone 5, and he would still be doing the iPhone 4. I'm going to get the iPhone 6 now. Here it is. That's what we're going to do. Same as we did with the iPhone 5. You know, unscrew this little area here. Just dig into a bit. Push it away. Lift up the screen. One side comes out. One side comes out here. On the other side, you're gonna want to take that out as well. Have that open, have that under, drop it, lift it up, and then it unclips. This is an iPhone 6S. Bobby built it all himself, but this is what the iPhone is actually like. So we're gonna just quickly examine. This is an iPhone 6, guys. Screen. Just a bit floppy. The Apple battery, SIM card slot on the side, which he has no tray. That's where the SIM card goes, right where my little finger is, if you can see that. On the side, Bobby's still working on the iPhone 4. Lightning port goes into a little area which touches onto the battery, and it goes into the battery. That's an iPhone 6. It's a real iPhone 6, and the iPhone 4, it's turning on. This is a jailbroken iPhone 4. Bobby's going to turn it on and just go do some random things just to show you it works perfectly. Perfect, it works. So, he's just going to wait for it to turn on. Bobby actually uses an iPhone 5 because the iPhone 6 he made and it doesn't work, but it's still a good accomplishment from Bobby. Go on. Not yet. And with the iPhone 6, guys, that's what's entitled in iPhone 6. In another video, we will go further into the phone and take out every bit, which we'll do in another episode, another video. But this is just really just showing what's inside an iPhone 6. So guys, we're going to wait for Bobby, the iPhone 4, to turn on. And I'm just going to close up the iPhone 6 here quickly. I'll just put my camera down. Probably there. Just slide it back on and you just clip it into every area. Bobby will do that because I'm new. So basically, you just have to do from the front where the little front-facing camera is, close it in, and just shut around everywhere. But guys, this is an iPhone 6. taken apart or opened up, which is that's no excuse. iPhone 5 works perfectly, fully taken apart, all the batteries out and everything. And most importantly, the hardest one of all, the iPhone 4. Turn off again. Turn on. It's probably shut off. Shut down. So, the iPhone 4 is not turning on. It's just because we bloody powered it off. Yeah, see, it's turning on. It takes batteries out. Oh. We know how to do things.
Don't
break your phone. Just turn it on. Just turn the phone on. We know how to do things right, guys. Postman, black postman. Pat only black and white yet. Oh my god. It sucks. He's had it for 7 years. He got the first month it came out, he bought that phone. Yeah, you know why? Why is it that whenever I want something to happen right, it never happens? It always happens wrong. Anyways, you saw that iPhone 5 worked. iPhone 4 turned on. You saw it turn on. We turned it on. And it just turned off because I was clumsy and I dropped it. We're just checking the battery and stuff. We know how to get things done though. Ah, now it's turning on. See, we put the cover on. Drop it again. It keeps on turning on and off. You know, we're a failure. No, we're not. It works, guys. Trust us 100%. We're just going to make sure it turns on. Because, look, it's on. It's on. It's on. It works. See, it works, guys. Now, Bobby's just going to put the back cover on. That's my computer. Actually, an iPad. The tools that you're going to need for doing this is that little really thin screwdriver. My phone's turning on. Another little screwdriver thing, double-sided little thing. I don't know what that's called. What's that one called, Bobby? That, this one? He doesn't know. Little tweezer thingies. A phone to work on. An iPhone 5. And an iPhone 4. So, guys, this is what we have done in this video. We need to be congratulated because we suck. I'm going to level this up. We're going to take a quick photo, because why not? But guys, yet again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned. Next time we will do another one of these as well. Hope you enjoy. We're waiting for the iPhone 4 to turn on again because it's so slow. But until next time, guys. This is good. We're going to do more videos. Oh, it turned on. We got proof. We're sliding it open. 000. So we just set that password for the thing. See? It works perfectly. Perfect. It's jailbroken as well. So perfect. It works absolutely perfect. That's like my favorite word now. Perfect. Perfect. So he has Bobby has jailbroken his phone. I don't know why. It's just turning on. And that's why he's got the weird water icons. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you did watch, tell all your friends, bring all your friends next time. Remember, go to Procase Melbourne. Procase. Thank you again. Next video, I have no idea what we'll do. We'll plan something, Bobby and I. We might do something another time, but until then, guys, peace out. See, Bobby wants to say one last bye. One last bye from Bobby.
Bye.